Hello, welcome to a new session where we are going to discuss about Cucumber report. So in basically Cucumber, we have two type of report. One, we get it with the help of like PT, HTML and all, which will be like feature file detail report, where each feature file, what are the steps has been run and what is the status. If it is green, it will be like pass. If it is red, it is fail. So this report generally come when we give in the runner class, like if you see here, like we see plugin as a pretty and where to generate. So it is like HTML type of report which will generate in a target folder with the folder called Cucumber HTML report. And there is another report which will generate, which is a cucumber.json. And there is another JUnit report we generate, which is cucumber.xml. So we generally refer this Cucumber report to see if our scenario has passed or failed. Okay. So in Cucumber, we have two types of report. So one is this report. Another is a Cucumber JVM report, we call it. Cucumber JVM report generally come from Jenkins. But if you want to generate this report in your local, while running from the Eclipse or IntelliJ, you can do so. So let's talk about the first report. Okay. So when you go into runner class, you can give like plugin as pretty and the target folder where you need to generate. Along with that, you need to mention mandatory like cucumber.json to generate the second report, which is called a Cucumber JVM report. So Cucumber JVM report will generate when you run from POM or you execute whole project. But this report will generate whenever you run a single feature file also, or single annotations also. Okay, fine. So we are going to talk about this report now. To generate this report, we need a cucumber.json file basically, which will get generated when you run any test. Okay, and we are going to generate this report only after all the execution has been got finished. So this type of report generally generate from Jenkins, but we want to generate in our local, so we will do it. Okay, so let's talk about the how to generate the report first. So what you need only one jar, and then the phase, in which phase it should run. So now I think you might be aware of the Maven phase. If you are not aware, you can go to this websites and you can just simply type Maven lifecycle, phase lifecycle, and you can see it. So these are the phase basically in the Maven, where like validate, compile, test, package, verify, install, deploy. So the moment I say clean install, it will do one by one wherever there is a phase is mentioned. If no phase mentioned, then it will start from first and it will do everything. If you have mentioned the package, it will do the package. If you have mentioned the test, it will do the test. Test means it will run the JUnit classes. Verify, it will verify the integration test to verify the criteria are met or not met. Install, we generally what we type, clean install, Maven clean install, basically we give a command. So it will execute. So what we'll do, we'll give a phase, like in which phase it should run. Our HTML report, our JVM report should execute when? After all our test cases has got executed. So where is the test phase? Test phase is above the verify. So we have given the verify. So this is a jar we need it basically. So you can go and search for this Maven Cucumber reporting jar into the Google. You'll get the latest version. I think latest version 3.16.0. Okay, you mention it, but you need to mention under the plugin, build under that plugin, and you have to give. Now where we are executing that test, when all our execution has got finished, all our test execution has got finished, then only we are executing. Now what are the what are the other things we can mention there? We can give the project name or the report name. So same report name will come, you can see it here. Same report name will come. or project name, whatever you want to make. Then the build number, you can see this is a build number here, correct? So this build number, you can mention it, which build number you are executing or what you can mention. Okay, date also you can mention it, means date it will take automatically. So you don't have to mention anything, date it will take the date you will execute it and what time you have executed. Then we have this. Okay, so let's come to the feature form.xml. So we have written that. Now output directory where you want to generate your report. So there is a output project build directory, inside that you generate Cucumber JVM report. The moment I say project build directory, it will take the project root directory and it will go into the target. Anything which gets generated by the Maven is all goes into the target. As you know, the class files, the bytecodes, everything gets generated, even the reports are get generated into the target folder. So this target folder, it will get generated. So you can see it, I have two type of report. One is Cucumber HTML report, another is Cucumber JVM report. Okay, so we are giving the path. Then we are saying where is the cucumber.json file. You can give anything, json.json file, abcd.json file, any name, but we generally give cucumber.json file. So it will read this cucumber.json file and then it will generate the Cucumber JVM report, which is similar to this report, which is a Jenkins report. You will get it generally with the pie, with a chart here. Okay, and then the how many feature file, everything. So let me show you in this, so it will be more like what are the feature file has got executed, how many steps are there in each feature file, and then how many pass, how many fail, how many pending, everything it will give you. Okay, then scenarios, each scenario how many like steps has got passed. These are the scenarios basically in this feature file. These are the scenarios and these are the steps. Okay, and whether the whole feature file is pass or fail. So this status give whole feature file pass and fail status. Okay, this will give the scenario status, this will give the step status. Now if you want to go inside that, we'll talk about that, what are the other details are there in that project. So let's see how we can generate it. Then you can give the consuming JSON file. So consuming JSON file is basically from target folder, you can see it. So we have given project directory slash cucumber.json, you can see it, project directory inside the target directly it is there. Okay, now you can give enable flash chart. So the flash chart you are getting it, I have made it enabled, that's the reason you are getting, otherwise it can disable it also. So you can put it false. As I was talking about the build number is this. So you can give 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever you want to give, you can give it. Okay, so this is how you generate the Cucumber JVM report. Now my question is how to run it. That is very simple. Just click on the pom.xml or on the project and then do run as build with Maven and give clean install. This will generate. I'm not running it because it is already generated, so I don't want to, because it will take some time, like 30 minutes to run all the test cases. So I'm not generating it, just you give it, it will generate it. Okay, so just remember what you need. You need a plug, you need to put this jar into a plugin. Okay, okay, and then you have to give the phase, verify phase. So test phase will come first, so all the tests will get executed, then only the report will get generated. Okay, and then after that, once you go into the folder, just refresh it and you'll get the just two folders are there. So if you go there inside this, you need to open this file. If you open this file, you'll get overview, means whole details. But if you want to go into details, you can go there and you can see what happened to each of the file, means for each of the scenarios. You can see this got fail. If you want to see the attachments like reports, this is embedded of reports. I will talk in later new videos. Thank you for watching this session.